holy shit, what a fucking conference that was. 50 games, 18 exclusives, and 15 world premieres, and almost all of them look good. Can you believe it? It wasn't just a bunch of useless announcements. Out of all of those games, there are probably only 5 that I didn't even care about. This is most definitely the best conference that Microsoft has ever put on, hands down. But, and this is a big but, ladies and gents, was it enough? I know that sounds insane considering how good of a show Xbox just put on for us, but how many of those were actually exclusives? Seriously, could somebody tell me? They used the word exclusive too many fucking times in too many different contexts. I legit have no fucking idea what I can actually buy. Let's talk about some good stuff, some bad stuff, and then some super duper ultra interesting stuff. I'm not gonna be able to cover absolutely everything, there's way too much there, but I'm gonna do my best to talk about absolutely everything that made my pants just a little bit tighter. Let's start with the smaller and more indie-like games. First off, we got Ori and the Will of the Wisps. It looks so bloody beautiful, I wanna cry. I was, however, surprised to see a 2019 release date. I guess it makes sense though, this doesn't really seem like the kind of game that would thrive in the fall release date. We got yet another game from Don't Nod. It's called Captain Spirit. The first episode releases for free on June 26th. It's set in the Life is Strange universe and it looks pretty heartwarming, although this is starting to worry me a bit. That's now 3 games that we know about from Don't Nod to be working on. We've got Life is Strange 2, Twin Mirror that was announced just a few days ago for PlayStation, and now this. I'm all for it if they can manage it, but this is starting to stink of Telltale. We'll just have to wait and see how this one turns out. There was also a new Idea Xbox hype trailer that showed a lot of cool looking indie games off. Too many to mention here, but here's a few of the more notable games that were in the trailer. There was Cuphead, the delicious Last Course DLC, which is slated to release in 2019 and also introduces a brand new character, Miss Chalice. It's unclear what kind of variety she'll add to gameplay, but I expect that this now means there's at least 3 player co-op, and of course the DLC will also add a bunch of new bosses for us to fight as well. Tunic was also shown off. It's basically an isometric Zelda clone with a cute fox in it, and there is nothing wrong with that. One of my favourite games of the last few years is Hyperlight Drifter, and that's pretty much a Zelda clone, and I adore that game. But did you know that Tunic is being developed by one man named Andrew Scholdice out of Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada? What a hard-working young man. Looks like all that hard work is about to pay off pretty soon, Andrew. Keep on fucking that chicken. And for the eagle-eyed viewer, there was a quick snippet of Below in there as well. I've been following this game for about 3 years now, and all we know is that it's slated to release sometime this year. I swear, by the power of George Michael's spirit, if this game gets pushed into 2019, I will eat Phil Spencer's fucking toes. Just kidding, Phil. Love you loads. But seriously, where's the fucking game? The last indie title I want to talk about made me flip my fucking lid. Session. I was spazzing out so hard I thought I was gonna need a carer by the end of it. I was convinced that this was Skate 4. Convinced, I tell you! But alas, it was not meant to be. It's not all bad news though, because correct me if I'm wrong, we're still getting a new skateboarding game. If EA isn't gonna put out another Skate title, if they for some reason refuse to fill that section of the market, then someone else is gonna swoop in and take it. And why not have it be these guys? From the little that we saw, I'm actually pretty fucking excited for this game. Oh, and if you're wondering what makes this an indie game, Session was actually funded on Kickstarter within 3 days. You can say what you want about Kickstarter, but every now and then it gives us something so amazing that it just makes me want to suck its dick. Now then, let's move on to the big AAA games that were announced. First up to bat, would you believe it? It's From Software, along with Activision of all publishers, with what was formerly known as Shadows Die Twice and is now known as Sekiro Shadows Die Twice, which looks bloody awesome. He's got some kind of skeleton grapple arm, I think. Hell, I don't know, but it looks bloody cool. It's clearly a Souls-like game. I mean, did anyone expect anything different? But it looks incredibly fast-paced and even a little wacky in some areas, which is kind of strange considering the initial announcement teaser made it seem so much more dark and serious, but who cares? It still looks cool. Oh, and I was right about the Japanese writing thing, so that proves that I'm not racist.
No, it doesn't.
We got to see some actual gameplay for Metro Exodus this time, and my God, this game looks nice. Perhaps most interestingly, though, it's also coming out on February 22nd, 2019. That now makes 3 games with that same release date. We've got Metro, Anthem, and Days Gone. There is no way that all of them stick with that date, and in a surprising opinion, I think that Anthem will be the one that moves. Not because it's scared of the other games or anything of that nature, but because I'm not confident that it's even gonna hit that date. Who knows, maybe that'll be best for it anyway. I've been seeing a lot of people say how they prefer to play Days Gone rather than Anthem, which is something that I did not expect to see at all. However, I have been getting a lot of my information from Twitter, so you can probably just disregard that last statement. I was quite surprised to see that Division 2 was also there. This time it's set in Washington DC, 6 months after the initial outbreak, and it's set to release March 15th, 2019. Is anyone starting to notice a pattern? It seems like devs and publishers have finally realized that you don't have to release your game in the fall for it to be successful. People buy games at all times of the year, although I doubt I'll be buying this one. It just looks so bland to me, like I really don't care about it at all. But you know, as usual, if you like it, then more power to you. I hope you enjoy it to its fullest when you get it. Something else that I was surprised to see at Microsoft conference was Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I really thought that this one would only be at Square's conference. We still don't know much about it, but from what I've heard from Kinda Funny Games' Greg Miller, it's actually really dark. Apparently Lara hangs guys up Batman style, but then she stabs the shit out of them. You know, like that one prison cell scene in Breaking Bad. Yeah, I know. Sounds pretty fucked up, don't it? Arguably, one of the biggest games of the entire conference was Devil May Cry 5. Can you believe it? And on Microsoft's stage as well, it's been 10 years since Devil May Cry 4, and the devs know it. It was awesome to see how confident and passionate they were about the game. They know the fans are hungry, and they are gonna feed them. And as far as the actual trailer goes, it looks pretty fucking insane. Also, I haven't really played a lot of the Devil May Cry games, but this one looks a lot more modern than Devil May Cry 4 did. That one had more of a Roman Catholic religious vibe. But either way, the game has a release window of spring 2019, and I am excited. And I've never even completed a Devil May Cry game. Don't burn me! I'm gonna get around to it, I promise. Something I didn't expect coming at all was Jump Force. What a fucking terrible name, by the way. Even despite the name though, it looks awesome. I'm not a fan of fighting games or even anime, but this one looks so out there that I might just have to give it a try when 2019 rolls around. Another nice surprise was Dying Light 2. I love the way that they showed the game off. There was so little emphasis on zombies, which says to me that this game is about far more than that. Choices seem to be a massive gameplay feature as well. Whenever a dev says that your choices matter, I always stop and ask, but do they really though? But with Dying Light, it looks like there's actual consequence to the way in which that you choose to play, and that's refreshing to see. I know the choice is incredibly difficult to implement correctly in a game, and I know we haven't seen much of the game or even something fully in action yet, but props to Techland for looking like they're really giving it a go. Just Cause 4 showed up as well, and it's got fucking tornadoes! But until we see some more of this game, I'm gonna lower my expectations, because Just Cause has a great reputation for being fucking insane and not playing very well. And for the final third-party announcement, the one more thing, Cyberpunk 2077. It was only a cinematic trailer, but we got a better idea of how the world feels, and this world looks incredible. I cannot wait to explore it. The only thing that doesn't sit right with me at the moment is the voice acting of who I assume is going to be the main character. He seems a bit more of an edgelord style character rather than a more serious Geralt style character. However, I will reserve my judgment for the final game upon release. Okay, now that we got all of the big third-party announcements out of the way, let's talk about the first-party exclusives. And unfortunately, this is where we start to get into the negatives. The show opened with a brand new Halo titled Halo Infinite. Halo was supposed to be big news for the Xbox brand, but they didn't really tell us anything. I bet there's a few Halo nerds out there that can squeeze some info out of this, but I ain't got a fucking clue. Halo itself isn't the bad part though. The bad part is the first-party exclusive lineup as a whole. Throughout the show, we saw Forza Horizon 4. I don't care for racing games, but I'm British and this one is set in Britain, so it's already on my side. We saw another trailer for Crackdown 3 and we got Terry Crews being Terry Crews, but nothing majorly exciting on the gameplay front. Finally, there was Gears 5, which also had an underwhelming showing. I know it's just the announcement, but I at least expect to feel engaged in one of Xbox's biggest franchises. The biggest problem wasn't even the fact that none of these games grabbed me, it was that I expected them. There wasn't a single new game that I had no idea about. I was kinda hoping for a new IP. However, this is where we jump into the really ultra cool super interesting stuff. Microsoft announced that they acquired 5 new studios. 5! Did you hear that? I said 5. Fucking hell, that is a lot. Especially to announce all at once. One of them, the Initiative, has been created from the ground up, and the other one was Ninja Theory, which is insane. Most of you probably know Ninja Theory for Hellblade, as you should, because it's a great, great game. But they also made Heavenly Sword, which is a PlayStation 3 exclusive. That's big fucking news. That's not why the studio acquisitions were cool though. It's cool because it shows that Microsoft are serious about providing players with new experiences. While they may be doubling down on existing franchises, they're also going in hard on first-party exclusives. And while we may not see anything from these studios for 3 to 4 years, it means that Microsoft are gonna start the next generation with a bang. The final thing that I want to mention before I end the video is that Microsoft announced that they too are investing in cloud gaming. This is big, folks. This is really big. A lot of companies are trying to get a piece of this pie. I'll be putting a video together on this topic soon because it's far too important to just slap on the end of this video, so look forward to that. All in all, Microsoft did a damn good job this year. While they may not have had the best first party lineup, the third party announcements and the 5 new studios more than make up for it. This was a big year for Microsoft, and I think they did all they could to win us over. And although I can play almost all of those games from the conference on my PS4, I am seriously considering getting an Xbox just to prep for the future. Seriously though, where the fuck is Below?